In the early 19th century, during the First Industrial Revolution, there was a sharp rise in the production of thermal machines, such as locomotives. The development of thermodynamics explains the limitations nature imposes on such machines and their energy costs. Nowadays, we can build smaller and smaller thermal machines, and if we keep shrinking them, at some point, we shall face the bizarre phenomena of the quantum world. How can we master heat at the quantum level? This is the field of quantum thermodynamics. In almost every home, there is a thermal machine, the fridge. Thanks to a motor, it pumps heat from the cold inside to the warmer outside, keeping refreshments cool. A fridge with a quantum motor is a quantum fridge. Quantum fridges can be built on microchips and can serve many uses. For instance, since entanglement hardly stands the heat, you can use one to keep electrons, Alice and Bob Cooper, entangled. Let's see how Miss Penguin, the scientist, keeps them quantum cool. The quantum motor is a superconducting qubit that has two possible states: the up state at higher energy and the down state at lower energy. The scientist can tune the energy of the up state between two values, low or high. When low, the qubit exchanges quanta of energy with the cold environment. When high, the qubit exchanges quanta of energy with the hot environment. Let's play. When the qubit is in the down state, quickly lower the energy of the up state. When the qubit is in the up state, you should quickly raise it. In this way, you remove energy from the cold environment and keep Alice and Bob cool and entangled. Understanding the mechanisms that govern heat exchanges at the quantum level, scientists improve the performance of quantum devices. Quantum physics must go hand in hand with thermodynamics, a theory so universal and fundamental that none of the great revolutions in physics have ever challenged it. In the words of the cosmologist Sir Arthur Eddington, if your pet theory is found to be contradicted by observation, well, these experimentalists do bungle things sometimes. But if your theory is found to be against the second law of thermodynamics, I can give you no hope. There is nothing for it but to collapse in deepest humiliation.